If you're like me, you absolutely love those television shows where there's great mystery around the characters, where we don't know if a specific character is a friend or is a foe. That mystery is what draws us into a particular show, whether it be NCIS, Madam Secretary, or any of the shows that you might watch. Well, this mystery exists in the negotiation process as well. Many times when we sit down at the table or we prepare to have a negotiation, we don't know how the other side is approaching the same conversation. We don't know if they're coming to the table as a friend, ready to be cooperative with us, or if they're coming to the table ready to capture as much value as they can as a competitor. And so this mystery requires us to manage it really, really well. And I want to give you three ideas that I think can be useful to you in managing this dynamic. The first is this, and that is we have to know the nature of the game that we're playing. The way that we learn that is by asking questions, by having some conversation about process, by perhaps asking for some concessions. And in that, we got to read between the lines to try to decipher whether or not we're dealing with someone that is ready to be cooperative or perhaps is ready to be competitive. Our response will largely be as a result of what we read between those lines. The next thing to know is that we cannot be cooperative in a competitive negotiation. Otherwise, we'll lose. It's about that simple. There are many games that can be played that demonstrate this over and over and over again. If we try to be cooperative, if we're willing to put value on the table, when we don't know whether or not someone is going to give us value in return, we can become very, very vulnerable. And as a result, we can lose and lose big time. So we've got to make sure that our cooperation is rational, that it's strategically called for. Now, for some of us that are more cooperatively inclined, this is a very difficult moment because we want to try to demonstrate cooperation and hope that that will influence the other side. But the reality is that if we're too cooperative and the other side is really competitive, we'll actually incentivize the other side to be more competitive, not less. The last thing you need to know is that there is a cost to competition. Some of us, we've enjoyed great success as a result of being very competitive. But the reality is that competitive has a relational cost. It's hard on relationships. The famous oil tycoon J. Paul Getty once said, "If I have to make every penny in a deal, well, chances are I won't have very many deals." And so, as you go out to negotiate, as you encounter this mystery, remember those three things, and that will get you to a great strategic place to where you can deliver an outstanding outcome. One of the things I want to remind you is that I am eager to answer your questions as part of this video blog. And so I want to encourage you to email me a question at john@lowrygroup.net. Email me whatever questions, whatever challenges that you have, and I'll be eager to respond to those in an upcoming blog. Thanks for watching.